rolling into town. Filthy pennies and crunched up dollars. Bought this ticket, time to get unwound. If music's your reason to be, makes you feel so wild and free, grab your boots and get ready to hang with me. Some horns if you wanna rock out with me.
Yo, bro, let's go.
Meet me in the front row at the punk rock show. It's where we're born to go. Meet me in the front row. We'll sing.
Thank you. Great, man. How are you, Charlie?
Good. The cops haven't come, but I have to tell you, that's officially the loudest we've ever had here on the Pittsburgh Current Concert Series. Thanks for coming out, guys.
We wear that badge proudly. Thank you.
So, Chip Demonic, why don't you introduce the band real quick to the folks at home?
Sure. Back there on drums is Ed Gourley. Over here is on guitar is DJ Carruthers. Just played his first show with us as a member of the band at Dutchtown Music Festival. And over here, it's the pretty face above the bass, Melina.
Chips.
Just 17 years old.
Wow. It was a great great first two songs. And Melina, you were fantastic.
Thank you.
Don't want to say that you stole the show, but you kind of stole the show. So, Chip, folks know you around Chip Demonic. We've known you for years around the Pittsburgh music scene. Heavy metal. Hair is the word that often comes into mind. Hair metal, sort of. What's with the new band? How is this different from what you've been doing, and how are you liking it?
Well, it's kind of like all based on best summed up with our album titles, Flow of the Current.
Yeah.
Chip Demonic, who DJ was a member of up until 2016, had stormed the Pittsburgh music scene more on the harder edge, borderline metal, punk side of things.
Sure.
Late 2015, my parents both became ill and had to live with me under my 24/7 care, so had to step away from music for a while, at least publicly.
Sure.
Now during that time, I was still writing music, just not out there performing it. And it's like I always tell the story, like, I was getting my parents ready for bed. Like, my mom would brush her dentures, and she would brush her dentures for like 45 minutes if you let her.
Sure.
So that was kind of like my time to like write music. But that situation isn't like conducive to writing wall shaking metal music. So
right.
I started writing music a lot on an acoustic guitar, and that's kind of how the sound of Chip of the Charge Up started to take place. So Flow with a Current really represented just a flow of whatever I was feeling currently during that time, and just writing song after song, one at a time. And then that's how the Chip and the Charge Up sound kind of got started, and we've been growing it from there.
Yeah, so obviously out of necessity, but also was it where you were, was it the place that you were when you started writing like that? And was it also, not just like out of necessity, but were you also sort of feeling that's where you were at that time?
Yeah, very much so. And I think that's kind of embodied by the song off of Flow of the Current Part 1, Shine Again. Like, yeah. It was a very difficult time and a very challenging time. But I knew that is the right thing to do. And I knew that, at some point I would have the opportunity to do music on the same scale again. And that's kind of how Shine Again like encapsulated everything that I was going through at that time, and represents, this step towards where we are today.
Absolutely. So, obviously we have to talk about the family connection here. Melina, when did you and your dad start? Well, let me ask you this first. How long have you been playing music? When did the interest start? Obviously it was around your house probably your whole life.
Yeah, since like the day I was born, I pretty much wanted to be a musician. I think when I really started to know that I wanted to really actually do it for like in a band, mm-hmm. or on my own, I was in third grade, and that was the year that everybody got recorders, and we all got to play the recorders.
Oh, yeah.
We had a teacher who taught us stuff, and I kind of just like excelled above everyone else.
Yeah.
And they, I think they even like added new levels so that, you know, I think there was like me and one other person who were like competitive. But yeah, I was that was when I realized I was like, oh, this is like actually something that I'm good at too. And then after the recorder, I picked up the bass, just went from there.
Rest is history, at least recent history, because I'm sure you got a long way, long time in this business, I think, coming. Chip, what is it like for you to play with your daughter in this concert?
It's been awesome, and it's had like so many benefits that I never expected. And this was actually not an intentional thing. You know, when I formed Chip and the Charge Ups, you know, I was looking for bassists, and you know, you don't think ahead of time, like, you know, it'd be really cool to start a Partridge Family type band and have my kids and everything in it. But so I was, you know, she has her life, I have my life, and you know, I'm a father, she's a daughter, so it was just like, yeah, I'll just form this band. But you know, we would schedule auditions with bass players, and most of the time they would like flake out and not show up, and they'd be like, I didn't know today was Tuesday. It's like, ooh, I don't think we're going to reschedule you. Or they'd come and they wouldn't be a good fit or whatever. And Melina would be in the house, and she's, you know, obviously a very talented bass player, and be like, hey, Melina, the bass audition's over. You know, would you mind sitting in? And then so she sat in and learned a few songs. And, you know, it happened again, learned a few more songs and a few more songs. And then it's just like, wow, this is like really working out and fitting well. And then, you know, obviously, as we just heard, you know, she's not only a great bass player, but a great singer as well. Yeah. And so it was just like, wow, that, you know, Melina is like blowing away any bass player we could audition. So we played one show, and it was just so magical that it's like, this is right. This is Chip and the Charge Ups. And she became a member of the band, and we've been rocking ever since.
That's amazing. Chip, you've been obviously you've been a part of the Pittsburgh music scene a long time. And this is Love PGH Music Month, as we all know, and you can check out lovepghmusic.com for up-to-the-minute bookings, like what live bands are playing every night. You can check that out. But Chip, how have you seen the scene progress through your time in it?
Oh, it's been like night and day.
Right.
You know, I started playing out regularly in the Pittsburgh music scene around 2005, and I got to tell you, 2005, 6, 7, 8, 9. You know, well into 2010, and it was very bleak. You know, you'd play a club, and if you got 13 people in there, like above that threshold of 12, it was a good night. And, you know, it was just everyone you talked to was so morbid about the scene. Like, you talk to other musicians, be like, yeah, the Pittsburgh music scene sucks. And it was hard to get people up, hard to get people excited. And it was, you know, really radio was almost non-existent for local music, except for maybe the Clarks. And it was just terrible. And there was no light at the end of the tunnel. And then all of a sudden, you know, four-ish years ago, it was just like a big snowball rolling. Yeah. And all of a sudden, like, you know, music festivals, obviously Deutschtown was a big one, but we got to pay homage to the predecessors, Rant and the Strip District Music Festival were a big part of that. And then, like, with the radio stations, 105.9 got the local listen every night, played local music on Edge of the X and 97.7. And then publications like the Pittsburgh Current start covering local music. And then all of a sudden, all these, you know, it was just like everyone was starting to say, or influential people were starting to say, Pittsburgh music's cool. And then someone else, other influencer would be like, Pittsburgh music's cool and Pittsburgh music's cool. And then all of a sudden, we have this amazing music scene. Yeah. And it's, you know, it's just unreal having had the perspective of what it was like before the last few years.
Right. And it's funny that you mentioned the Clarks. And I think at that time, a lot of people, when they thought of what is Pittsburgh music, they thought, not that I love the Clarks. Mm-hmm. I listen to Clarks all the time. But now we have such a diversity in terms of genres and musicians. And it's a really great time, I think, to be a fan in Pittsburgh music. Forget about being a band. I guess it's probably great for you guys too.
Yeah. And, you know, you're so right about the diversity aspect of it, because the multiple scenes are strong. And, you know, it's like the singer, songwriter, folky type music in Pittsburgh is very strong. The rock scene, the metal scene, the punk scenes, these are all strong on their own. And, you know, I'm excited to see if we can do some cross pollination and, you know, the folksy music, fans are starting to listen to maybe a little bit harder rock stuff, mm-hmm. or maybe the harder rock stuff starts discovering the folkier music, and maybe some people looking from metal to punk or punk to metal. I mean, I think the opportunity for cross-pollination can only make our scene as a whole stronger.
Absolutely. And you mentioned the Wichita Music Festival. Talking about when you started in the scene, could you imagine that there'd ever be a music festival in Pittsburgh, 400 bands all sort of playing over 2 days?
Well, it's kind of funny because there's a little known article that I wrote on my Tumblr in April of 2012, I think. Hmm. And it was called 25 Ways to Improve the Pittsburgh Music Scene. And one of those ideas was, would someone like a promoter just throw the scene a bone and put on a big free music right. festival? And, you know, so I kind of saw that as an opportunity, you know, and hoped that someone would. You know, at that point, again, it was pretty bleak back then, so I don't know if I was optimistic that it would happen. But I always thought that that would be a way, a big way, you know, to really grow our scene and make a dent. And it has.
And you guys played there this weekend. What was yes. that? What was it like? And how does it compare to previous years?
Well, it was great. We got to play on the Skyline stage this year, which was great. What we liked about that is that because we were out in the open and on a big stage,
right.
we got to capture a lot of passersby. Mm-hmm. And what was cool about that, like one thing that we take pride in of Chip and the Charge Ups is that we do have a diverse audience. And, you know, sometimes we look at our crowd and we see kids from 7 to, you know, seniors in like 70, mm-hmm. and everyone seems to enjoy themselves. And being out there in the community, you know, it was great. We got to see a little bit of all of Pittsburgh, a little bit of all of America, with people of different backgrounds and everything stop by and enjoy our music. So that was awesome. In terms of comparing to previous years, we played at the Elks Club in 2018,
right.
and that was a blast in itself. I mean, that was more of a bar party vibe,
right.
so it was different, but it also just it was a lot of fun as well. So, you know, both were the apples and oranges, but both very tasty fruits.
So I know you guys have a couple of shows coming up, which I'll ask about, but in terms of writing music, new releases, what do you guys have coming up?
We are writing all the time. We are hoping to get back into the studio next month to continue recording on our third album. We already have 3 songs recorded for that. Hopefully get a few more done next month. We like to do like 3 songs at a time, mm-hmm. To give the each song the opportunity to kind of grow and ripen, and then go into the recording studio rather than doing them all at one time. So we hope to continue with that next month and have another release out in spring of 2020.
Great. And you guys play this Friday at Spirit at 7 p.m. Part of the, lift the glasses up, Suicide Rebellion benefit.
Mm-hmm.
And then on July 27th at 3 p.m., you play with the Borstal Boys at Leo's Sports
Page.
Page is my page. It's my beautiful handwriting in New Kensington. Fantastic. We're glad you came here. We're glad you were here to celebrate Love PGH Music Month, and we love listening to you. So what are you going to play next?
Well, thanks so much for having us here at Pittsburgh Current, and what we're going to play next is actually a track off of our first album, and this is a mashup of 2 songs, a song by Poison and a song by Green Day that we mashed up, put on top of each other, and this is called Good Riddance, Fallen Angel.
Chip and the Charge Ups.
You by the wrist, direct you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, in the end it's right. I hope of your life. Win big, mama's falling each day. Lose big, living out of line. Wants it all, mama's falling each day. Hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frame in your mind. Like too much too soon or just a little too late. But when the ship came in, she wasn't there and it just wouldn't unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you have the time of your life.
Cool, man. Now we are going to actually play one of the songs that we have recorded for our third album. So this isn't out yet on iTunes or Amazon or any of those places. So you get to hear it early. This is called This Bomb Ain't Gonna Light Itself. We're like a barrel of explosives, 55 gallons set to blow. We're gonna show 'em how to live hard and leave a crater in this road. Day turns night, ready, aim, ignite. Hey! Get in the game and don't be tame. Fire up the flame. Let's cause a scene and make them scream. Spit gasoline.
This bomb.
We're like a fleet of loaded tankers. This thirsty city needs our fuel. Engulfed in music, love, and blue lights. We dance on hot and burning coals. Day turns night, ready, aim, ignite. Hey! Get in the game and don't be tame. Fire up the flame.
Bomb is gonna light itself.
Let's cause a scene and make them scream. Spit gasoline.
Bomb is gonna light itself.
This bomb. The wick, crank it up, let's get sick. Strike the match, touch the wick. We're like a barrel of explosives. 55 gallons set to blow. Get in the game and don't be tame. Fire up the flame.
Bomb, you're gonna light it go.
Let's cause a scene and make them scream. Spit gasoline.
Bomb, you're gonna light it go.
Get in the game and don't be tame. Fire up the flame.
Bomb, you're gonna light it go.
Let's cause a scene and make them scream. We're going to do one more song for you beautiful people out there in internet land. And some of you, even if you're not all that familiar with Chip and the Charge Ups, may be familiar with this song, thanks to our friends over at WDVE, playing this all hockey season long. If we can get our guitars tuned, we will play it for you right. And it's like 1,000 degrees in here, man. But we're loving it.
Is it hot in here or is it just me? You're supposed to say, oh, it's just you. That would be more flattering, but yeah, I guess it is hot in here. All right, cool, man. Well, I think these guitars are in tune enough for government work, so we are going to do the old 2-9er. Time for hockey talk. This is gonna rock. There's no one finer than the old 2-9er, master of the puck. Better listen up. There's no one finer than the old 2-9er. The old 2-9er. The old 2-9er. Can you handle the legend that awaits? All he scored, couldn't do no more. There's no one finer than the old 2-9er. He hears the river call when the boys win it all. There's no one finer than the old 2-9er. The old 2-9er. The old 2-9er. Don't be fooled by the smile that is oh so sweet. Whoa. Put men on the ice searching for their teeth. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Pry your ears, let him tell you what is up. Whoa, whoa, whoa. He's a man with his name on the silver cup more than once. Yeah! Whoa, 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 whoa. The old 2-9er. The old